Hello everyone, I'm TJ Kohli, Creative Director at Monogram. Monogram is a digital agency from Atlanta, Georgia, who specializes in building Jamstack websites and web apps using the latest technologies like Next.js, Tailwind CSS, Algolia, and headless CMSs like Prismic, Datto CMS, and Contentful. Monogram's been a longtime user of Vercel, and we're honored to have the opportunity today to present the MacStadium website and its process with everyone.
Hi, I'm Heather Robertson, and I'm Vice President of Global Marketing at MacStadium. MacStadium provides cloud solutions for developers who are building for the Mac ecosystem. So essentially, DevOps teams and developers that are building iOS or macOS apps need Mac hardware to be able to build and test their apps. And what MacStadium does is we take that consumer-grade Apple hardware and we enable it with networking, connectivity, storage in an enterprise-scale data center environment and provide that to them through a cloud so they can actually access and use Mac hardware the same way they would with Azure or Google Cloud for their other projects. Originally, our project was we wanted to re-enable and redesign our customer portal to make it easier and more user-friendly. So we were looking for a company that could do a lot of UI and UX design for our web portal. And then in talking about that project, we also realized it's probably a good time to refresh our website. So then our scope kind of expanded to being not only app UI and UX, but also website design and build. And so that's kind of what led us to Monogram, is we knew that they would excel in both areas. They also are a local Atlanta company, and we're here in Atlanta, so it was a really nice opportunity to get to work hands-on with a company local and side-by-side, which we haven't had a lot through the pandemic, and so that made the project even more exciting for us. One of the things we're really excited about in working with Monogram is moving our website to the Jamstack. And so we had been using a platform that had some CMS elements to it, but it was still basically a WYSIWYG web editor. And we were running into some problems where we were limited by how big the site could go, how much we could scale, how much unique customization we could do. And what I really discovered in this whole process was between using Prismic and Next, we were able to do everything that I wanted from a scalability standpoint. And it was really extensible and really customizable. And working together with TJ and the Monogram team, we were able to come up with some really unique things that gave us a lot of customization as far as design and content and execution for our website that has been really, really exciting. One of the benefits of going with a Jamstack website and having it more componentized and API enabled and more flexible, secure, extensible is that we really can use this website and grow in the future. MacStadium has a lot of plans for the next couple years, and so being able to take the same backend, the same content, the same CMS and apply that to not only our website, but our blog and our portal and new products that we're developing all from one place and also change it and evolve it as we go along to kind of fit our needs. That was really exciting for us. Platforms that we've been on in the past were pretty static and it was just our public website, our marketing facing website, where now we can kind of take the same website content and expand that to be more broad across the entire organization and benefit not only marketing, but product and customer engagement and things like that. So that's a really exciting part of it that we're looking forward to growing with Monogram.
Next.js has a great developer experience with zero config install, which is ready to go within seconds. And it provides a lot of functionality out of the box, like auto-optimized images, prefetching links, deferred loading of scripts, code splitting with dynamic imports, hybrid SSG, SSR, incremental static regeneration, or ISR, TypeScript support, and API routes. In a unique digital agency like Monogram, we're equally versed in building websites and web apps. Due to the versatility of Next.js, our developers are able to work side by side within the same framework. It's easy to pick up and works great whether it's for a small blog or a large enterprise website or web app. A Next.js project can be as small or as large as you need. Multiple options for generation allow building a website or an app as SSR, a SPA, or ISR. Hybrid generation enables cross-app unification. For MacStadium, we chose SSG, or server-side generation, and ISR, or incremental static regeneration, for the perfect balance of speed and build times. The integration ecosystem is very strong with Next.js. Vercel offers one-click CI/CD deployment, no managing servers, no dedicated CI/CD team necessary. Slack notifications for errored builds make it easy for us to know when issues occur. Vercel Analytics enables performance testing with every single build. As one of many small ways Vercel and Next.js improves our workflow, Vercel environment variables means no more sending .env files to each other in Slack, and it also means we can keep our API keys secure. A bonus side effect of Monogram switching primarily to Next.js is that recruiting is now simpler. We do not have to hire or build complex cross-platform teams. Everyone is a Next.js developer, and those switching from vanilla React love the convenience Next.js brings. Being agile and moving people across projects enables Monogram to stay lean and provide the level of service our clients expect. We started with low-fidelity wireframes in Figma. We used our design knowledge and experience, worked closely with Heather and her team, and performed user testing with Usability Hub as needed. Iteration in this phase is key. Since this was a big brand refresh for MacStadium as well, we brought creative art direction and worked very closely with Heather to establish a clear vision of MacStadium's new aesthetic. After many rounds of iterations and refinements, we settled on a new rich purple-based color scheme that perfectly complements MacStadium Orange. Prismic played a key part in building this Next.js website, as it was essentially our backend and data repository, as well as the client's interface. Monogram definitely stretched what is possible with Prismic and the slices feature, and innovated in a few key ways that made this project a success. We'd love to show you and walk you through some of these innovations today. The first of these was the way we apply themes to a slice. As you can see from the design, it was not enough for us to have every slice look the same with a white background. We wanted Heather and her team to have flexibility in choosing a theme for every slice to be able to control the look and feel of a page. For example, certain pages could be dark while others could be primarily white. A theme was created as a repeatable content type in Prismic and simply had two fields, a title and a unique ID. The unique ID is written as a class on the slice via a custom Next.js slice zone we wrote. This is passed as a parameter to every slice, and if no theme is chosen, our Next.js code has a fallback to white. In Prismic, everything is optional. There are no required fields. Some may consider this a minor annoyance, but this is clearly a fundamental design decision taken by Prismic rather than a shortcoming, and we took full advantage of it. By wrapping every text, image, and embed field from Prismic in a conditional statement, Heather and her team had additional flexibility with slices. For example, a logo party slice without a title could serve as a simple grid of logos, while the same slice without logos and only a title could be used as a standalone title. This expanded the number of slice variations to the millions. As you can see here, another innovation was our custom Prismic Next.js slice zone. Essentially, it's a Next.js component that accepts Prismic slice array for a page and renders the correct slice in its place. We use the switch case statement here, as you can see, because it performs better and is less memory intensive than if-else conditional statements. One of the requirements for building this website was that certain pages had to be grouped together within directories. For example, company-related pages needed to be under /company. While the obvious answer for this may be to create a company type in Prismic, we did not want to duplicate all the parameters that we spent building the general page type, so we devised a better solution. We leveraged Prismic's tags as the method to filter the getStaticProps query and conditionally build only pages tagged with company under the company folder. The footer navigation is being built entirely from Prismic, which is great for MacStadium to maintain links moving forward. However, this posed a challenge for us when building pages with SSG. With hundreds of pages, we did not want to query Prismic for the same data for the footer of every single page. So we're using Node File Sync, or FS, to download the globally used data once and use it to build the rest of the website. In any large-scale enterprise website, it's important to have lots of internal links between pages. The challenge with many Jamstack websites is to properly maintain internal links from a content perspective. So we're leveraging Prismic's internal document link feature, and we wrote an innovative yet simple link resolver function that automatically finds the correct URL based on the past items. This is built to be foolproof and can accept a URL string, an object, or even an array. As a cherry on top, we wrap this in a CTA button component to unify the styling of the button site-wide. The CTA button component is essentially a Next.js link component styled to look like a button, and these are used throughout the website, with the label, type, URL object, and more being passed through. This also was helpful in implementing segment analytics. We simply wrote segment code into the CTA button component, and it all just works. Next.js websites are blazing fast right out of the gate, but if you're not careful, it's easy to add heavy external scripts, fonts, and large images that can lower your performance score. Although we're super careful about adding even a single package to the project and undergo a thorough internal performance review, Vercel Analytics performance helps us keep tabs on whether a certain build caused a significant performance decrease. It's also a bit of a challenge to performance when external analytics scripts can cause a severe performance hit, but that's when Next.js script tag and up-and-coming plugins like PartyTown come to shine. We're watching this part of Next.js very closely, and we are working very closely with the Vercel team to find ways to keep performance at 100% while simultaneously loading external libraries needed in the enterprise. Looking forward, we have a bright future in our partnership together with MacStadium. We are working on some really great things together, all using Next.js. For example, Monogram is working on an in-house Next.js animation system that keeps animations at 60 FPS and doesn't impact Web Vitals performance. We're working closely with Next.js engineers to help bring Next.js live to MacStadium and others, and can't wait to see what the future holds.
We're really excited about everything that we're doing at MacStadium, especially partnering with Monogram. We've got a lot of really cool tools that we're building for our customers to really enable them being able to build for Mac in the cloud.
Jamstack technologies are rising every day with Next.js at the core. Monogram believes technologies such as Next.js to be key instruments in the Jamstack orchestra, and we can't wait to create a symphony together. The future is only getting started, and the future begins today.